You've set classroom learning goals with each student. You've planned effective assessments and gathered feedback. But how do you know if a student is really moving forward on their pathway to success? By collecting data. It is essential to collect data on student performance in order to know if a student is proceeding toward their classroom learning goals. Collecting student performance data will help the teacher see if a student has taken a detour on their pathway to success. If you aren't measuring your teaching practice by collecting data, how can you manage and optimize your practice? Just because you measure something doesn't ensure that you'll optimize it. But measurement is the first step. According to Albert Einstein, not everything that can be counted counts, and not everything that counts can be counted. There are two things to take away from this quote. First, not all data is useful for what you're trying to measure. While data is important, the right data is essential. Understanding the goal for which you are determining progress will help you select the correct data. Second, some teachers are under the impression that the term data only refers to quantitative or numerical data, but that is not the case. Data can be quantitative or qualitative, and each can provide valuable input into student progress toward their goals. The type of data needed to measure progress depends on the type of goal. For example, if the goal is a behavioral goal, the data is more likely to be qualitative, although it is possible to have quantitative data for behavior goals as well. In addition, sometimes it is a challenge to collect the data on what you want to count, but keep exploring new ways to get the data you need. There are low-tech and high-tech ways to collect data. Some low-tech data collection methods include using sticky notes, clipboards, and quick writes to see where a student is. In the high-tech category, there are commercial products that can be purchased, but you can also use Google Apps and other collaboration tools that are available for free. You can take videos and record audio too. You don't need any fancy equipment. A smartphone or tablet, or a computer with a web camera will do just fine. Remember that how you collect the data is less important than ensuring that the questions you are asking is giving you the correct data. It is essential to collect the correct data so you can make the correct adjustments in your instruction. For many data collection strategies, see the resources listed to the right of this video. What will you do with all of the data? Certainly, you will use it to adjust instruction, but make sure to keep formative assessment data in student portfolios as well. This will help provide a full picture of each student as they progress toward their learning goals.